students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding The Road Not Taken, written by Zia Mia and MV Ramanna. Now, from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies, mains, examination paper 2, plus this is important for political science optional students. Now, what is this editorial about? This editorial is about the skewedness and the asymmetries that currently are engendering the melee of disparity on the front of nuclear security. This editorial is also about how the Western world wants to maintain status quo on the front of nuclear security. Now, in order to understand this editorial, first of all, we need to understand about the relationship between the hegemony in the global diplomacy landscape and the benefits this hegemony accrues from having access to the nuclear resources. Now, the first usage of the nuclear weaponry was done during Second World War. Now, the usage of the nuclear technology, the usage of the nuclear weapon, since then has divided the world into the nations that were having access to the nuclear technology, to the nuclear weaponry and the nuclear resources, and such countries which still are not having access to nuclear technology. Now, the Western world, it has created a big chasm. It has created a big gap. It has created a big inequality in the diplomatic world by having access to this nuclear technology. Now, when Western world had mastered this nuclear technology, it don't want it to proliferate to the poorer nations. It don't want the uniform spread of this nuclear technology to the developing countries and to the countries that were lying at the second pedestal, or that were lying at the second level of the hierarchy in the staircase of global diplomacy. Now, the Western world had wanted to cement the benefit of the nuclear technology by the Nuclear Non-Proliferation Treaty. The Non-Proliferation Treaty wanted to stop, wanted to create blockades over the transfer of the nuclear technology. Now, this is something that the Western world has been trying since 1967 and 1968. And it had taken Western world about 45 to 50 years to keep on harping this thing again and again. Now, what the Western world is actually trying to do, what the Western world actually wants, it wants the asymmetriness, it wants the skewedness to sustain for a longer period of time. Because the longer this inequality, the longer this chasm will sustain, the more benefits it can accrue at the global diplomatic level. Now, when you look at the kind of the things that have created this inequality in the world, the foremost thing is the nuclear technology. The second is about the levels of technology that the countries possess. The third is about the GDP. And the fourth is about the trade asymmetries. Now, these four things create inequality in terms of the power, in terms of the authority that is garnered by the countries. Now, when the Western world has realized that it had failed to stop this proliferation, it had failed the spread of the nuclear technology, it had failed in restricting the spread of the nuclear technology, now it is getting wary, it is getting fearful, it is getting a lot of anxiety about how it can protect the world, how it can assure the nuclear security. So the question that the Western world now is facing is more about the nuclear security, because the proliferation regime that it had tried to unleash in 1967-1968 through non-proliferation treaty, it has not actually worked. After that, n number of countries had detonated this nuclear weapons, had tested these nuclear weapons, and there has been a lot of progress with respect to the vertical enrichment of the nuclear weapons. Now take the case of North America. It has developed myriads of nuclear weapon technology from the micro to the macro level, from the fission level to the fusion level. Take the case of the countries like India, Pakistan, Israel and North Korea. They all have developed the nuclear technology without being party to the nuclear trade regime or the nuclear trade rule system that was stabilized by the Western powers. Now the China tested the nuclear weapon in 1964, India did it in 1974, and Pakistan did it after India. So the countries in the world, they are having access to this nuclear technology. And the biggest problem is not about the scale in the nuclear technology, because you can create a lot of havoc in the world by few kgs of high enriched uranium and plutonium, weapon grade plutonium. Now this editorial has also talked about how a plutonium of that just weighs about the weight of an apple can kill hundreds of thousands of people. So how, what this conference has actually yielded, and what this conference actually wants now? This conference actually focuses on to protect the nuclear technology that the countries are possessing. Now this nuclear security summit implicitly wants that this technology should not be passing in the hands of the non-state actors. Now that is the big and the clear message, that is the clear intention of the nuclear security summit. So this is the fourth nuclear security summit. It wants the countries to protect their nuclear capacities and capabilities from falling in the hands of the less responsible outfits. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And in order to avail the information of the classes, please visit our website brainyias.com. And in case you've liked this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.